Hi children and hi viewers. In this video, I am going to explain about the electric potential due to dipole. Electric potential at a point due to the dipole. This is the one of the most important question for examination point of view for intermediate children. The same topic is also very important to the competitive exams also. It's a very important topic, and this is very important and very interesting too. Clear? So already in previous videos we discussed about the what is potential and what is potential difference and what is the relation between potential and electric field intensity. And in previous video we discussed about the electric field intensity due to a point charge. In this video, I am going to explain electric potential due to the dipole. Clear? So this is the topic for this video, children. Up to now, you didn't see my videos. Just go and watch the videos carefully. So after watching the previous videos only, you must come to here and watch this video. Up to now, you didn't subscribe my channel. Please subscribe my channel and like and share and comment the video after watching the video. So children, I am going to the topic now here. Today's topic is electric potential at any point due to an electric dipole. We know that what is mean by electric dipole. What is electric dipole? Electric dipole is nothing but two equal and opposite charges. Two equal and opposite charges are separated by some distance. That will be commonly known as electric dipole. Clear? And what is the potential? The amount of work done in bringing a charge from infinity to the at a point in the field and against the field. That should be called electric potential. And formula for electric potential is what? V is equals to W by Q. And next thing is, in previous video we derived electric potential due to the point charge. That is what? Electric potential due to the point charge is what? 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R. So we are going to use this formula now. V is equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R. That is the electric potential due to a point charge. So children, here now, first thing is electric potential at any point due to the an electric field. So to understand that, already diagram is on the board, it is there. To understand very carefully and to understand very clearly, I am going to draw again. I am explaining that again. So this is a one dipole, minus Q and plus Q. So here these two charges are separated by some distance, and the distance is here what I am taking, 2a. 2a is the length of a dipole. Clear? Minus Q and plus Q, equal and opposite charges, and they are separated by some distance. How much distance? 2a. Clear? After that, we are selected one point. That is the point P here. That should be at a distance of R. Clear? From the midpoint of the dipole. Clear? Now in this case, at this point P, we have to find out the electric potential because of this dipole. That is the concept for this video. Clear? We want to find out the electric potential at this point P. That should be at a distance of R. Clear, children? So here now, after that, here I am saying that the position of minus Q is A and it is B. Already it is there like that. Here I am saying now this is the A and this is the B. Clear? And already we know that what is the potential. V is equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R. What it is that? Electric potential due to the point charge. So by using that formula, we can explain the electric potential at the point P with respect of plus Q and minus Q separately. So here, first I am writing here electric potential. Electric potential at P due to the plus Q charge. Clear? Now, according to the potential due to a point charge, I am going to apply that formula for plus Q and minus Q separately at the point P. That means here V is equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by RD is the formula. I am using that. Here R is what actually distance, nothing but position vector. And in this case now here I am telling electric potential at P due to plus Q, plus Q. And tell me here what is the distance between these two? Yes, BP is the distance. That's why here we are writing electric potential V1 is equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R. Q by R. Instead of R, what you have to write? As PBR, BP, anything. I am writing this is PB. Now it is equation number 1. This is the electric potential at point P due to the plus Q charge. Similarly, by using the same relation, we are writing now here electric potential at P due to the negative charge Q, negative charge. Then what do you write? V2 is equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. Here what is the distance between these two? Minus Q and this is the P. And I am drawing like this. So this is what here? AP. Here again V2 is equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught minus Q by AP. Clear? That means what? V2 is equals to minus 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by AP. This is equation number 2. After that, to get the potential with respect of dipole, now we are extending. This is very very little bit we have to extend very little bit. So here now I am saying this is the midpoint O, and this is I am taking here OC. Clear? After that I am drawing one normal here. This is now AC. AC is one normal. Children, diagram is so important. If you can understand the diagram, then only derivation is very easy. Other very difficult. Simply, to find out the electric potential, we are extending the position vector by small amount like OC. OC is very negligible compared to the OP. That's why it is negligible. Here, OC we are extended. After that, what I am telling, we are taking this O. This is C and this is A. AC is one normal. AC is normal. And here angle is theta. I mean 90 degrees. Here this OP vector will make some angle theta, which is the dipole. Now this is the angle theta. Clear children? First we have taken dipole, and after that we have to take again point P. That should be the distance of R. Clear? After that, to find out the potential, just we have to extend the position vector very little bit by OC. Compared to OP, OC is very negligible. So after that we are drawing one normal here, that is AC. Clear? And after that here we are drawing one more normal onto the position vector like this. Onto the position vector I am showing like this. So here this is 90, this is 90, and I am taking this is D now. Clear? Here BD is one normal and AC is another normal. So that is we are showing here like that only. So this is the first thing, AC, and now this is a BD. Clear? So after that, watch carefully. The same diagram will be there. Simply by extending the OP just a little bit, after that on that line we have to draw the two normal lines. One is onto the minus Q and one is onto the plus Q. Clear? simply we are taken, this is the position vector that should be extended little bit, and after that we draw one normal from C to minus Q, 1D is there, and plus Q to the D, these two are the normals. So then we are getting some triangle should be like this. Clear children? So here now in this case, here what is the BP? BP is the distance from here point to the plus Q charge. Now here almost all here we are taking BP is equals to DP. Clear? So we have to consider, let BP is equals to, here BP is equals to DP, because in this diagram you are finding BP is not equals to the DP actually. But if you can take like this, at this point you have to draw the normal, almost all similar. To understand the concept, we are showing some lengthy, that's why you can feel that actually these two are not equal. But if you can draw at this position normal, then almost all they are equal. That's why simply you have to remember like this, here BP is equals to the DP. And similarly here AP should be equals to the CP. AP is equals to CP. Then substituting formulas, then what do you write? V1 is equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by, instead of BP what do you write? DP. And V2 is what? Minus 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by, instead of AP what do you write? Yes, CP. Now equation number 3 and this equation number 4. Clear children? So that is about the diagram. So for us some space is required, that's why I am erasing this one. Now in this case we have V1 is there, V2 is there, then I am writing here net potential V is equals to V1 plus of minus V2. Because already V2 is minus. So that means simply what you write? V1 minus V2. Then what you write? V is equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by, what do you write? DP minus 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by CP. Clear? So after that we have to take V is equals to 1 by, in this equation 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q is common. Then what do you write? 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q into 1 by DP minus 1 by CP. Clear? Now this is equation number 5. Clear children? Now we have to observe the diagram very carefully. In this case we have A, O, C. This is like this. Here A, O, and this is C, and this should be like this. Here what I am telling, this is the theta, and what I am telling, this is 90 degrees. A O C, this is A O C, and that what we are taking, this is the angle 90. That's why here AO is hypotenuse. So from the triangle, from triangle AOC, I am writing now cos theta is equal to what you write? Adjacent side by hypotenuse. Here this is the angle, and now this is what? Here what do you have? AO. So now AO is the adjacent side, and
AC is the opposite side. Clear, children? So like that, simply no need to confuse. Here we are having, this is now AO. Clear? This is the angle theta, and this is what C. We are saying that this is 90 degrees. So here AO is the hypotenuse. AO is hypotenuse, and OC is the adjacent side. Then what you write? Adjacent means what? OC by OA. What's that? OC by OA. From that, I am writing now cos theta is equals to OC by, what is OA value? Here A to B 2A, A to B 2A, A to O means what? A, and O to B also A. That's why here I am writing cos theta is equals to OC by A. Then cos theta is equals to OC by means what? OC is equals to, from that what right? OC is equals to A cos theta. Clear, children? Cos theta is equals to adjacent side by hypotenuse. So OC by OA, OC is the adjacent side, and OA is the hypotenuse, because it is 90 is already in front of, it is what you have, 90 degrees there. That's why here what right? OC by OA, that means cos theta equals to OC by OA. OA value is half of the dipole, that is A. Clear? So after that what right? OC is equals to A cos theta. Clear? And after that, similarly from triangle now, ODB. From triangle ODB we are taken. Again same thing, cos theta is equals to adjacent side by hypotenuse. Adjacent side by hypotenuse. So here hypotenuse is what? OB. OB is the adjacent side, sorry, hypotenuse, and this is the here 90D is there. 90 opposite what it is, what we call hypotenuse. This is the angle, and this one is opposite side. Now here OD is the adjacent side. That's why here what you write? OD by OB. OD by OB. Clear? OD by OB. What is the here OB value? Nothing but half of the dipole. Sorry, OB. OB value is what? Nothing but half of the dipole. That is what? A. So from that, what we write? OD is equals to A cos theta. OD is equals to A cos theta. Similar, same wording. OD is equals to A cos theta. So why we are deriving these two values means, for that I am going to now. Clear, children? Very simple. In this figure, we have to go for two triangles. AOC is one triangle, and next triangle is ODB is another triangle. From these triangles, we have to write the expression for cos theta. That's why what we get, cos theta is equals to OC by A. From this triangle, OC value is A cos theta. And we have another triangle, what is that? ODB. From that what we write? OD is equals to A cos theta. So why we are writing means, the reason is there. Here, how we can write DP? What is DP? DP is nothing but distance from positive charge to the that particular point P. That's why here, from figure, DP is equal to what we write? Here, I am writing now, this is OP. OP, what we require? We require DP only. No need to confuse, children. This is OP, and this is what? C. Clear? COD. Clear? CODP. What we require? We require only DP. What do you get? DP we require. For that, what I am writing here, OP minus OD. Clear? OP minus OD. Clear? Got my point, children? So from this figure, if you want to write for DP, simply what do you write?
OP minus OD. OP minus OD, that will use DP. So here I am writing DB is equals to OP minus OD. Clear? OP minus OD. Here what is the OP value? OP is what? Distance from midpoint to the that point what is we are taken, that is already R. OP is equals to, in figure OP is equals to R. That's why here OP is R, and what is OD? A cos theta. That means what? DP is equals to, what you write? OP means what? R minus OD value is what? A cos theta. So DP is equals to what? R minus A cos theta. And similarly from figure we are writing here, next thing is what? Already we wrote what value for DP. Now we go for CP. What's that? CP. So this is what CP, we require CP. Further simply what you write? OP minus OP plus OC. Clear children? Here already in equation number 5 we wrote the value for DP. Now we want to write the value for CP. For that simply what we take? PO plus OC. CP, here to here what is CP? So we require CP. For that simply what we write? OP plus OC. Clear? So from figure what we write? CP is nothing but OP plus OC. Here very simple children, this is OC and here to here OP, then CP is nothing but what? OC plus OP. So here I am writing OP means what? Nothing but R. CP is equals to R plus OC value is what? A cos theta. A cos theta. You observe children, OC and OD both are equal. Simply what is A cos theta? A cos theta. So here from figure what we derived? DP is equals to R minus A cos theta and CP is equals to R plus A cos theta. Now we have to substitute these values in equation number 5. Then equation number 5 we have to substitute. So here I am writing now, then V is equals to what you write? 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q into 1 by DP value is what? 1 by DP. What you write? R minus A cos theta. R minus A cos theta minus 1 by what you have? R plus A cos theta. No need to convince children, very simple. In this just we are substituting V is equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q into 1 by DP. DP value is this one, R minus A cos theta minus 1 by CP. CP value is what? R plus A cos theta. Already we are substituting the equation number 5. After that then we go for LCM. We go for LCM. Then what we get? Then V is equals to Q by 4 pi epsilon naught. Q by 4 pi epsilon naught into what write? 1 into R plus A cos theta minus 1 into R minus A cos theta. That means simply here I am writing by doing LCM, R plus A cos theta, R plus A cos theta minus R minus A cos theta by, children, look here, this is in the form of A plus B into A minus B. A plus B into A minus B. Just I am writing directly here. R plus A cos theta into R minus A cos theta. Got this one, children? So after that, you have to apply minus. Then what we get? V is equals to Q by 4 pi epsilon naught into R plus A cos theta plus of minus 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 of minus plus A cos theta by
Here a plus b into a minus b. That's what I am writing. R square into a square cos square theta. Clear, children?
Here a plus b into a minus b. A plus b into a minus b is what? A square minus b square. So simply I am writing here r plus a cos theta into r minus a cos theta means r square minus a square cos square theta.
And you have to observe here, this is plus r and this one is minus r. These two are cancel. Clear? Then what you get? A cos theta plus a cos theta. A cos theta, a cos theta means what?
2a cos theta.
What's that?
2a cos theta.
Then I am writing v is equals to q into v is equals to q into 2a cos theta by 4 pi epsilon naught into r square minus a square cos square theta.
Clear? So already we know that what is the dipole moment. Dipole moment is nothing but product of the 2aq. You will write what is 2a? Dipole length, and q is what? Magnitude of charge. The product of magnitude of charge and length of the dipole should be called what? We call dipole moment. So that's why here q into 2a, that is what? Nothing but p cos theta by 4 pi epsilon naught r square minus a square cos square theta. So this is the electric potential at a point due to the electric dipole. From that equation, what we have to conclude here? What you have to conclude? The electric potential is depend upon the dipole moment. At the same time, the angle made by the position vector with the dipole. Clear? V is depend upon r distance. At the same time, p is what? Dipole moment. And theta is what? Angle made by the position vector with the dipole. So that's why this is the expression for electric potential at a point due to an electric dipole. So here, see once again, children, this is a very important topic. I am going to explain very briefly, so you must follow it. So children, here there is one diagram. It is there here in the diagram AB. At the position A, minus q is there. At the position B is there. Here minus q is at the position A, q is at the position B, and the dipole length is what? 2a. So it is 2a. From A to O, it is A, and O to B, it is A. Clear? After that, at that point P, this is the point we are selected, that is at a distance of r. Clear? We are selected one point P, that should be at a distance of r from the midpoint of the dipole. At that point, we have to find out the electric potential. Clear? For that, here I am drawing here two lines. So this is one line that should be represents the distance from plus q to the point P, and this is the another line that is shows the distance between that particular point to the minus q charge. Clear? So already we have one equation is there. What is that? Electric potential due to the point charge. That should be what? V is equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by r. According to that, individually we are writing electric potential due to the positive charge and negative charge like this. Here, this is what? Electric potential at point P due to the plus q charge is given by 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into q by Vp. Here, what is Vp? Distance from positive charge to the point. And similarly, electric potential due to the negative charge is given by like this. V2 is equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught minus q by Ap. So after that, you have to draw the two normals. So simply, first thing is we have to extend the position vector in forward direction a little bit. Here you have to observe OC is negligible compared to OB. After that, we have to draw the two normals on that CP. Clear? One is from positive charge and one is from negative charge. So here DB is the one normal and AC is the one normal. After that, you are going to assume that BP is equals to DP. Clear? BP is equals to DP and AP is equals to CP. AP is equals to CP. So that's why here let BP is equals to DP and AP is equals to CP. And after that you have to substitute that in the equations. We will get equation number 3 and 4. V1 is equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by DP. That means here instead of VP what you write? DP equation number 3. And V2 is equals to and Q by CP. Instead of AP what write? CP. After that, now we want to find out the total electric potential. Total electric potential, the net, already we have V1 and V2 are there. Now we go for net potential, that is what V is equals to V1 plus of minus V2. So that's why we will get minus. So I am substituting values here, V1 and V2 already there. I am writing that point here. After that, in that equation, Q by 4 pi epsilon naught is common. So after that 1 by dp minus here this is common, then what you get? Q by 4 pi epsilon naught into 1 by dp minus 1 by cp. So now here we want to write the values for dp and cp. Now already in that equation what you have? Dp cp is there. To write the values for dp and cp, now we go for two triangles. So here one triangle is ACO and next one is ODB. From that triangle ODP, we will write cos theta is equals to OD by OP. OB means A, that's why OD is by A. That means cos theta is equals to OD by A and OD is equals to A cos theta. And similarly, you go for next triangle like this, OCA. From that what you write? Here this one is there. Cos theta is equals to OC by OA, then cos theta is equals to OC by A and OC is equals to A cos theta. So simply we write the values for OC and OD. After that, now from figure only we have entered thing. In figure what we write? DP means what write? We want to write DP. Look at the diagram, children. DP we have to write. For that we will take OP minus OD. OP minus OD. And next what you have write? CP. Simply up to here what you have? OP plus OC. So here like this, DP is equals to OP minus OD. Already OP values R and OD values A cos theta. So R minus A cos theta. Similarly CP is equals to OP plus OC. From that CP is equals to R plus A cos theta. Then after that V is equals to, some we are substituting the values there. We have to substitute the DP and CP values in that equation. Then V is equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q into 1 by R minus A cos theta minus 1 by R plus A cos theta. So after that, again LCM process, 1 into R plus A cos theta minus R minus 1 into R minus A cos theta, like that. So after that, we are applying the minus there. Then what do you get? R plus A cos theta minus R plus A cos theta. RR cancel. And it should be in the form of A plus B into A minus B. A plus B into A minus B. A square minus B square. Like that. Here R square minus A square cos square theta. And after that what you have? After cancelling the RR, we have A cos theta plus A cos theta. 2A cos theta. Then I am writing V is equals to Q into 2A cos theta. Then after that, what you write? 2a into q is nothing but dipole moment. Then v is equals to p cos theta by 4 pi epsilon naught r square minus a square cos square theta. This is a electric potential at any point due to the electric dipole. So after that, here we have special cases are there. That's very important. So here now,
Children, very, very important. The last three points are very important. So please wait up to last. So now here, what is the formula? V is equals to P cos theta by 4 pi epsilon naught into R square minus A square cos square theta. V is equals to P cos theta by 4 pi epsilon into R square minus A square cos square theta. Clear? So if we can consider A is so less than R, R is so greater than A, then A is negligible. Then what again? V is equals to P cos theta by 4 pi epsilon naught into R square. So this is the electric potential for short dipole. What you have to say? If you can consider a short dipole, the electric potential is what? This one. V is equals to P cos theta by 4 pi epsilon naught R square, because here A is very negligible compared to the R, that's why this term is going to be cancelled. Then what you get? V is equals to P cos theta by 4 pi epsilon naught. So this is the electric potential. This is the electric potential for a short dipole. Now we have special case is there. What's that here? Special case. The first thing is, at equatorial line. So that means, what is mean by equatorial line? Simply here, I am drawing here now. So this is a minus Q and this is a plus Q. Now at this is the point here P. So this is a dipole. How much it will make angle? Some theta. How much it is? 90 degrees. How much it is? 90 degrees. That means for equatorial line, the position vector will make 90 degrees with the dipole. So that's why here at equatorial line, what you take? Theta is equals to 90 degrees. Theta is equals to 90 degrees. So substitute here, V is equals to P cos 90 degrees by 4 pi epsilon naught R square. Clear? What is the value of cos 90? Cos 90 value is 0. That's why here, what we say, the electric potential at a point, the electric potential at a point on the equatorial line, at a point on the equatorial line is 0. Clear? This is the one is first most important. And second thing is, this is a special point, special case, second number, point number 2, axial line. For axial line, at a point on the axial line, at a point on the axial line, already in previous videos I explained what is mean by axial line and what is mean by equatorial line. Axial line means the horizontal line passes through the two charges, that is the axial line, and the line which is perpendicular to the dipole, that is what we call equatorial line. Perpendicular to the dipole, and that should be passes through the midpoint of the dipole, that is the equatorial line. So here now for axial line, now this is a minus Q and this is a plus Q. So now it is a dipole, and this is the here now, this is the point P. Clear? This is the dipole, the point is on the axial line, the point is on the axial line, the point is on the axial line. So for that case we take theta is equals to 0, theta is equals to 0, then cos 0 is maximum. Then what right? V is equals to P into cos 0. Cos 0 means what? Cos 0 value is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught R square. Clear? Axial line, the point is towards positive charge. The point is towards positive charge. That will be there. Then that time what will take? Theta is equals to 0 degrees. Then what we get? V is equals to P by 4 pi epsilon naught R square. Clear? And now if the same point here towards the negative point, towards the negative charge here, now this is the point P, that is towards nearer to the minus q,
then the angle will be taken as 180 degrees. If the point is towards positive charge, what you have to take, theta is equal to 0 degrees. If the same point is towards or nearer to the negative charge, then the value should be taken as 180 degrees. Cos 180 is minus 1, then what we take?
So this is where for positive q charge. And now if you can take third one, then what we get simply, V is equals to minus P by 4 pi epsilon naught R square.
So children, this is about the electric potential due to a dipole at any point and electric potential at a point on the equatorial line, electric potential at a point on the axial line. I clearly explained. So my humble request is you watch the video with patience. So don't skip the video. If you can skip the video, you cannot understand anything. Okay children, I hope you understand. If you can understand this video, like, share and comment the video and subscribe to my channel for latest notifications and press the bell icon so get the notifications. Okay children, we will meet in the next video with next some interesting topic. Bye, take care.